story to tell you guys before we get going to the main star of the show. About, if you rewind the clock 100 years ago, or maybe about 80, 90 years ago, there was this huge disease in the United States that lots of kids were catching every year. And all their parents were terrified that they were going to catch it because you lost your muscle control, you lost concentration, you lost your memory, you started having big growths coming out of your neck. It was really hard on kids. And does anyone know what disease I'm talking about? I heard some really good guesses, but no one said it yet. That disease was iodine deficiency. Someone say it? Alright, we got coming up, very good. Most people, I will go through a room of college graduates, most people don't know about it. That's great. The reason why most of us don't know about it is because in this country, there is no more iodine deficiency. It's completely gone. It's not gone from the world yet. There are some poor countries in the world where their children still suffer from it. But our country, our kids don't suffer from it anymore because we came up with a really simple solution to make sure no one got iodine deficiency. You know what we did? Guess what we did? I mean, what did we do, Mr. Feinberg? We put iodine in the salt, all your table salt. You know, so when you put salt on your French fries, but we don't serve French fries anymore in school, do we? But whatever, when you're home, whatever you put salt on, there's iodine in that salt. You can get a little bit of it, you sprinkle a little bit on, you can go to McDonald's and get a lifetime supply of salt, right? But that's how we make sure there's no more iodine deficiency. And think about that. We didn't put that in the salt just for the rich people. We didn't put that in the salt just for the white people or the black people or the brown people. We put that in the salt for everybody. Everyone in this country got that iodine in their salt. Today, in 2012, we don't have iodine deficiency anymore. But you know what we have? We have education deficiency. Clap for that. You know as well as I do that you have friends and neighbors in your community that are not on this climb with you. They are not making a choice to make sacrifices and work extra hard and be extra nice like all of you have. Right? So we need a cure for that. How are we going to deliver a cure for education deficiency? And we're going to do that by proving the possible. Not curing a few, but curing everyone. And today, as Mr. Contreras said, now over the century mark, we have over 100 KIPPsters who climbed the mountain to and through college. Watch this. If everyone in this room will please stand if you plan